What's good, my samurai? It's your boy Shebny out here with Royal Samurai. So today, oh God, I need to get this angle right. Today we are doing an oil change on my 99 Miata. As you can see, I already have it up on jack mounts. I am gonna raise it up a little bit more. And yeah, my phone is at 20%. So as soon as I get done with this little bit, I'm going to go put it on the charger. Also, with the oil change, I am also going to be doing a belt change because one of my belts broke this morning, which is why I'm not at work right now. So, yeah. But so I'm gonna get in so you can really see. If you look down, I might be missing something important down here. Yeah, there's no belt. Which means my engine's gonna overheat because it's a 0.8 Miata. And I need to fix this. Oh yeah. Now we have the Miata higher off the ground. So now I definitely can get to that oil change and do this oil change. Because that's what I'm doing first. I really want to get this knocked out before anything, because I am actually leaking oil. Somehow I managed to overfill the oil. I don't know how. I always put 3.5 quarts in, and that's what I did. And filled it. So, as you can see, this is what I'm showing you right here. I have run lines from where the oil was leaking out. I also just did a valve cover change. Not valve cover, valve cover gasket change. No, that's nice and tight. Make sure it was checked and everything, and it's good. But I guess since it's overfilled with oil, it's still leaking out. So I'm about to just get in here, change this out. All right, guys, little hiccup. Turns out I do not have the tool I need to get the bolt off of the oil pan. So I'm waiting on somebody to help me right now. But in the meantime, I can go ahead and start taking apart everything I need to get that belt on. Alright guys, so first I need to take off my air intake, which I really don't want to take this thing off. It just looks so good on the engine, you know? But let's see if we can get this here off. Gonna take this out of here. Take it out of the valve cover. I feel like it'll be the easiest thing to get off. There we go. Gotta take this out. Let's see. How does this come out? Alright, so there's a little tab right here that you have to push down. Anything else hooked up to this that I need to take off? Yeah, this. Gotta take this out of the master airflow sensor. That's on there pretty nice. Alright guys, sorry about that. I had a down for a second, but I got that off, and lastly I just need to get this mount off of the valve cover, and then it'll be ready to take off of the engine so I can get to everything down here. All right guys, so I managed to find my handy dandy wrench. I call these things wrenches. If they're not called wrenches, oh well, they'll be called wrenches by me. Okay, let's switch to the right hand, the hand that does everything. All right, so looks like, yep, just gotta, that is tight. Let's flip that over. Nope, I'm retarded. Lefty loosey, right? Okay. I'm sorry. I'm just having the best of time with this. Wait a minute. That's loosened, so I gotta break this thing off. How tight did I tighten this? Oh god, let's get that camera angle, you know? Yeah, I'm having like the best of time. There we go. So, funny story, I was going through my trunk and I cleaned it out because for some reason I keep my life in my trunk. Cleaned it out, and if you look right here, that coil pack is missing a bolt. Well, I found my handy dandy bolt in the trunk. Now, the person I got this car from did everything wrong on the old engine. And I'm guessing this guy forgot to put that back in there and just threw it in the trunk to do it another day. And I'm just now finding this thing. I know I didn't have it because when I did the engine swap, we couldn't find that other bolt. It wasn't on there. There's one on the bottom. Back there somewhere. There it is. There's one on the bottom right there. And there's one on the left. Right there. It's terrible angling, but let's see if I can get it. You can see it somewhere, I guess. I think. I don't know. But it's over there. On the left. So I found that bolt. So now I can put that back on the top. So now that we have this off, this will just wiggle right out of here, like so. I can take this completely off of the engine. And there we go. No more errand taking. If you guys are wondering, this is an eBay errand tape. It does pretty well. It's getting to that point where I might need a new filter. But yeah, I've never seen one of these with this covered. So does this come off or anywhere? Does it come off? No. No. You didn't see any of that, but yeah, I'm sorry, I'm still getting used to recording with my phone. That does not come off. I don't want to mess this up. It was expensive, it was like $60, so, but I mean car parts, right? And there we go, now we have a open manifold. Alright, so that's what we need to do for that. And I believe that is a... Use the finger. I believe that's a 14 inch socket or 14 whatever socket that I need to put over that. And basically that will allow me to adjust the power steering fully so it will be loose enough to take this belt off, because I have to take this belt off before I can go in and put the new belt on. So, we're just gonna get to that since I can't do the oil change right now. Alright guys, so unfortunately I wasn't able to get us taking it off, or get me taking it off, because the guys that let me use the tool are finished with their job and they had to go. So I want to hurry up and get it, but as you can see, where are you?
As you can see, it's draining right now. It's almost out. I'm just trying to get it to the point where it's dripping so I know it's almost finished. Once we do that, then I can go give this guy his tool back and we can be on our way to finishing this oil change. That oil was super dark, but now it's clearing up. I'm guessing the oil that I put in it previously is finally coming out with it. But yeah. And now it's dripping. So we're gonna let that drip a little bit more and then we're gonna put that bolt back on and keep going with this oil change. All right guys, so we got the oil out and got the bolt back on. I really didn't want to hold them up too much longer, so I just went ahead and did everything else while I could. So now we're going to get this oil filter off. You know, we gotta lube it up a little bit, put a little bit of oil in it, not too much, don't fill it up too much, and get this oil change going. God, I had a burp and a little baby burp came out. Well, fuck, baby burp. Nobody care about no baby burp. All right, so let's get this oil filter. All right, guys, so I got the oil out. Here it is. Put it in this little bottle or jug of water, what used to be a jug of water. And yeah, this is ugly, like really ugly. It smells like burnt oil. That don't smell good at all. Not one bit, but we got it out. All right, so now we move on to the next phase. Oh yes, there's phases. The next phase of this oil. We're just gonna put this cap on real quick. And there you go. Now I can take this to AutoZone and turn it in, cause I don't know what to do with this. And YouTube said take it to a parts store and they'll get rid of it. So yeah. That's what we're gonna do when we finished. So yeah, now we're all good on that. And next thing is
get this here oil filter out and put in the new one. So yeah, we gotta figure out how we're gonna get to that.
All right guys, as you can see, I put the car back on the ground. I'm just running into a lot of hiccups today, but that's fine. Oh God, I keep putting my finger in front of my camera. And we're back. All right, that's getting edited out. All right, so yeah, back to what I was saying. I don't remember what I was saying. What was I saying? Yeah, so I'm having a little bit of trouble because I do not have the tools to finish this job. So I'm waiting on a couple of friends to call or text and tell me if they can help out. But yeah. All right, guys, so this is taking a lot longer than I expected. We just have a lot of setbacks, but I did manage to get that oil filter on, so we're good on that. Now, I put some oil in the car. I didn't put exactly the amount that I needed in there, only because I didn't want to accidentally overfill it again. I don't know if I told you, but somehow I managed to overfill my oil, and I don't know how. I put the same amount in that I always put in. I looked at the stick read empty, so I put 3.5 quarts in. And that's usually what I put in there to be safe. I believe the exact amount is like 3.8 quarts or something like that. So I usually just stick with 3.5 to be safe. So I put 3.5 in and I checked the meter a couple days later because it was leaking oil really bad. And it was like twice the amount of oil in there. I have no idea how that happened. So yeah, I needed an oil change anyway, so I just want to go ahead and knock that out. But I told you that I couldn't get the filter off, so I actually went to Advanced Auto and picked up this nifty part right here. This is a oil filter wrench, if you don't know what it is. And basically use this to clamp down on it, squeeze really tight, and you just keep getting it until it comes off. If yours is really stuck on there like mine was. So here is the filter that I have on right now.
You can see it down there in the engine, that red thing under the, God, I can't think of the word, under the manifold. That's the new filter. I don't know, I got it from the Advanced Auto. That's it right there. Get the old one off and the new one on. And the oil from that old one is definitely old and dirty. But yeah, just make sure you loop this up. Fill it up, not to the point that it's full. Just put some in there, so there's already some in there. I just put a little bit in and just roll it around so it can reach everything and loop up a few of the parts that I can touch. But yeah. Right there, and now all I need to do is find a 14 inch, I keep saying inch, I don't even think it's inch, a 14 socket, long socket, so I can loosen that up and then loosen the tension pulley for the, God,
for the power steering.
God, I need to do something about me not being able to talk as fast as I think. Or think as fast as I talk, whichever way that goes. So yeah, we're gonna get that and get this knocked out. Alright guys, and here is the old oil filter. Just thought I'd show you this before I threw it out.
Yeah,
you can see like old residue in there, and yeah, this definitely needed to be changed. I hadn't changed it in probably like 15,000 miles, which is not good. Definitely needed to do that. My car, I believe, is every 5,000 miles is when you need to change the oil. It might be every 5,000 or every 4,000.
But yeah, I don't know. If you guys drive Miatas, please tell me. I might be way off on that. But yeah, about to throw this thing out. You can see right here where I really had to grip that thing to get it off.
I destroyed this oil filter. But yeah, so I'm about to throw this thing out.
Alright guys, everything's done. I got the belts on and everything. Didn't get to record it. My phone was almost dead, so I had to put it on the charger. But everything's running good now. Got everything cleaned up on the car, hood back down, off the mounts, and everything. So, we are all good. That was the video. Peace. And remember, look at me looking at all extra black and red and whatnot. Good Lord Jesus. I've never been this black in my entire life. Man, I look like a goddamn shadow. Oh my God. But no, remember, if you don't think you can do more, you ain't doing enough. All right, I'm out.